So coding questions in online assessment round was pretty easy for me. On the basis of that, they actually judge you, like how would be your behavior. So they don't just stop the interview there. What they will do, they will ask a follow-up question. They will increase some parameters. So hi guys, welcome to Coding Ninjas YouTube channel, and I'm Yash. And in this video, I'm going to tell you about how I prepared for Amazon and how I cleared the interviews. So in this video, we are going to briefly discuss that how I applied for Amazon, how I prepared for it, what was the interview structure, and what were the questions asked from me, and in the end, how I was able to grab the offer. So this is a video in which we will properly discuss all this content and step, right? I will discuss not only about my experience, I would also give insight about Amazon India. Like I am going to work for Amazon Dublin, but Amazon India is having a slightly different process than what I am going to share with you today. So we will discuss both the aspect so that in one video you can get a clear cut idea how you are able to prepare for the Amazon and clear the interviews. Also, I would like to tell you about Coding Ninjas YouTube channel. So Coding Ninjas YouTube channel brings a lot of videos like journal long, journal short, technical videos, interview questions, live sessions, and a lot of things. So I would also like to tell you that your placement season is coming in a couple of months, and it would be great that if you are watching these videos, you'll be having a better sense of what are the things going to be in a couple of months and how you're going to manage the stuff. Also, it would be great if you would like to subscribe to the Coding Ninjas YouTube channel and hit the bell icon so that you get notified for every new video. Let's start with how I prepared for the Amazon interviews. First of all, let me tell you that I was very much fascinated by the work that Amazon is doing right now. Like it is one of the best providers for cloud services, and I have always been amazed over the cloud services that how we are actually maintaining stuff, scaling stuff out there. If there is a single application, how multiple more than millions of users can actually interact with it. For example, let me tell you that Arogya Setu app in India managed a lot of data, a lot of connections that, okay, this person is vulnerable to COVID because someone who has a close contact within last week was suspected with COVID. So how this stuff was actually managed and tracked with the help of AWS services at the backend. And not only about AWS, I was just fascinated about the cloud services. Hence, I prepared for Amazon, applied in multiple openings. And I would like to tell you that I didn't took any referral. I just go to the career portal. Sorry for the if there is spelling mistake. Yeah. Okay. And career portal, I saw there are a lot of application for new grads. And in that, I just applied with the Dublin one. Okay. Not only with Dublin, there were Germany, Luxembourg, Finland, a lot of. Okay. So career portal, and then applied with the Dublin one. How the things proceed ahead? I got a mail in which I was told that there is an online assessment round. See, in the online assessment round, there were two coding questions. And these coding questions were needed to be solved around 70 minutes. Okay, so 1 hour, 10 minutes was given the allocated time to solve this coding question. These were kind of easy to medium question, in which one of the question was on array manipulation and other question was on some basic dynamic programming. I would like to tell you that under 25 minutes, I was able to solve both of the questions easily. So coding questions in online assessment round was pretty easy for me. How I prepared for the coding actually. So before my online assessment round, I was given like 4-5 days of gap so that I can prepare for them and then perform it. Like there is a window in 4-5 days, I need to attempt that. So I actually had my own earlier notes on various topics. Also, I practice a lot of questions. And right now, like many of my friends are actually following this platform named as Code Studio. So Code Studio is a coding platform that provides free online editor and compiler in various languages like Python, Java, C++. And it is the one of the best platform to prepare for upcoming coding interviews. It contains top interview questions, their solutions, and guided path to various topics in data structures and algorithm. So do check out Code Studio platform, right? What happened is you are able to learn in a structured manner. Like Code Studio platform is maintained in such a way that there are guided paths, there are problem sets, top interview questions. You can also see interview experiences. So Code Studio is one stop solution, I would say, if you're preparing for coding interviews. So for coding round also, I use Code Studio and also use other platforms like LeetCode and GFG. So earlier I used to solve a lot of questions on GFG. So I had seen the earlier question like, okay, this was one of the toughest question that I was not able to think in once. So I solved it again, and that's how I practiced seeing my notes and everything. Right. Next, after 2 days, I got another mail that it was a work assessment round, and it was told to me that in the work assessment round, we need to have a simulation. Okay, so in simulation, what happens is that you are given some of the problems. Okay, you are having a mail intercept, and you are getting a mail from your senior, and they are having some debates, and how you're going to interact with them, how you're going to actually give out your answer, your opinion. That is how you're going to interact in the real world also. So on the basis of that, they actually judge you, like how would be your behavior. And for preparation of this, I would say I didn't prepare anything, and I also recommend don't prepare anything. It's just how you are actually. So be yourself, just with a fresh mind. Whatever judgment you are taking, whatever analysis you are doing, just be sure that you are doing it correctly. Okay, you are from your own heart is performing that judgment that in real life also you would do though. Okay, so simulation round was around 1 hour or 1.5 hour, and it was also a pretty normal simulation. Like there were different tasks I need to solve out throughout the mail. Okay, next thing is the interview. So after like 4-5 months, I got my interview calls, and in the interviews there were a lot like times given to me in which I can perform. So there were I chose a time slot, and there were 3 rounds. Okay, so in these 3 rounds, what happened is, first round is there, then there is a second round, then we have a half an hour break. So there is a 30 minutes break, 1 hour interview, second interview 1 hour, and there is half an hour break, and again there is a third round. Okay, 1 hour. So this was the structure of overall process. So it started for like 3.5 hour. I was totally occupied with the interviews. Perfect. So in all the interviews, there was a similar structure that I saw. First of all, a 5-minute introduction with my interviewer and what I am and what is like my qualification, my college, and what is my degree, what I'm pursuing right now. So next 25 minutes, I had a behavioral round. So in the behavioral round, what happened is that they ask questions on situations, like some of the situations are there. And in those situations, for example, let us take that you are assigned some project and you actually overachieve that. You actually complete those tasks, and apart from that, you add additional features and something. Have you done so in your past? And if yes, how you are? So you need to answer properly on the basis of your judgment, your projects and everything. There could be questions like, hey, have ever you received a critical feedback from your manager? Also, there could be questions like, okay, there is some of the time slots given to you and you were not able to complete your deadline, and how you shifted the deadline, or what did you do? Okay, so everything they ask on the basis of behavioral. Next, for 25 minutes, there were like coding rounds. So in the coding rounds, you can see your questions on basis of array manipulation, based on graph. Like for my first interview, it was on array manipulation. In my second interview, it was on OOPS concept, kind of like classes. I need to make some functionality of a parking lot design. So it is some kind of system design plus OOPS, but a low level. Then I had another round, in which third round, in which I had question on graph topological sorting. So in topological sorting, I need to actually first of all see the problem itself. Like problem won't be straightforward, there would be of some story kind of thing, and in the story kind of thing, you need to actually check out, okay, this is a problem and how you are going to actually deduce that, okay, this should be the algorithm, and I deduce that it is a topological sorting and I applied that. This is how the coding round behaves. And if you complete your coding question, like in all of my round, I was able to complete my coding question before the 25 minute mark, so they don't just stop the interview there. What they will do, they will ask a follow-up question, they will increase some parameters. Okay, in parking lot design, okay, now there is not only single gate, there are multiple entry levels. Okay, in array manipulation, there is not two inputs, there are array of inputs. Or in topological sorting, as I have completed it, how would you test your solution, what would be the edge cases you would like to see, and everything they discuss. So they ask for follow-up also. And in the last 5 minutes, what happened is that you can ask any of the questions that you have in your mind to the people out there, and this will actually help you to also clarify like how enthusiastic you are about the company you want to like impress the interviewer and all. So B, make sure that you have prepared the list of the question, you have prepared the introduction pretty well, you have actually gone through all of your projects, whatever situations you have actually felt and how you would relate the questions that are given in a behavioral round to yourself, right? And again, for coding question, you know how to prepare for that. As I mentioned, Course Studio is one of the best solutions that you can go ahead. So this is all about my interview experience. Let me tell you also about the Amazon India experience. So in Amazon India, the structure is very similar, apart that instead of behavioral round, there is a coding round only. So they really emphasize only on DSA, no core subjects, like little bits of oops they could ask, but DSA is asked, like two coding questions, 25 minutes each, and DSA is pretty much like they want a proper optimal solution. So Amazon India really grills you on the DSA concepts because there are a lot of applicants and they want the best people that are able to solve DSA question as soon as possible and in optimal manner. So time constraint is there, DSA questions with optimal solution they want, and similarly like in international also in coding round they want optimal solution in time constraint, but in Amazon India you have to solve two questions, not one. So this is how the slight difference is there in Amazon India. All right. So this is all about my experience, how I prepared for it, how I actually made my introduction and sourced many of the situations online. There are multiple videos online and how I actually move ahead. Okay. So this is all about my video. And if you have any doubt, do comment them in the comment section below. Do like and share the video if you really like this. And do subscribe to the Coding Ninjas YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so that you get notification for every new video. Bye bye.